Blog Talk Radio.
Peace. You are now listening to the Lions Out the Cage Blog Talk Radio program, brought to you by the LOTC Leadership Group, the People's Language Media Group, and Supreme Lifestyle. We are not here concerned with your feelings. We are not here concerned with your emotional response to the truth that you should have long ago accepted. The Lions Out the Cage show is dedicated to the representation of positive thoughts and efforts, and not blowhard rhetoric and misdirected energy. Although both Brother Martin F. Muhammad and Brother Philip A. Muhammad are registered members of the Nation of Islam under the leadership and guidance of the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan, this show and nothing that the hosts say should be seen as the official position or stance of the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan or the Nation of Islam, unless otherwise noted. Remember, you are now in the middle of a sucker-free zone and a hypocrite's worst nightmare. To that end, we warn you that the host and the guests might be subject to the occasional use of baby language, for no man can be successful in teaching a people that cannot speak clearly the people's language, and therefore parental guidance is strongly, and I mean strongly, suggested. So with that being said, stand up, don't relax, and get ready, for the lions are out the cage.
God set this up, but it's time now for this new line of leadership that is coming up to let all those of you who want to lead our people. You're either going to lead not for vain purposes and not for self-aggrandizement, but all of you that want to lead our people should pledge your life if you turn against the aspirations of this people. You should pay with your life. And until you're ready to pay with your life, then get out of the leadership business. Because we, the new leadership that's coming up, we're not going to take that mess.
Yeah.
Lime Nation in power, circle and circle the game. Circle your name on a circular plane. Hold my pockets in the sky and assert in the rain. Take a trip into my mind, now you searching for pain. I wear a size 13, boy, you must be insane. If you think you're size 9, go put me to shame. Me and the whole crew, we better go through. Some of the illest tracks you heard that are known too. Flip your mind with the civil round and civil enough. Check your time if you tapping out or giving it up. Power circle, get the cream, say yo. Yo. The Lime Nation on the scene, make way for Y.O.
Y.O. A rebel in his own mind, taking charge of the post, and you know I'm on mine. Got to kill him with the flow, so you know it's kind of mine. Got a message for your dope, tell me in my own time. Farrakhan, harder than I think you need to listen to him. Gotta get some knowledge, if you're not, I don't know what you're doing. All about the hunger, keep it steady, we're consistent, moving. Tearing up the Constitution, about to start the revolution. Yeah, fuck King James, I'm more like King Tut. Weak-minded niggas get hit with nunchucks. MC Hammer flow, you can't cut. Snap on beat, two-step, and get booked. The God MC that once was a mortal, till I step through the end of my portal. Kicking so many waves like Eddie Gordo. Beats on tracks for days, they have a gordo. Letters from the government, the straight up to my residence. Say I'm sitting presidents, we're making dead presidents. Niggas say they got the truth, but they be lacking evidence. 10% is 1 and 2, fuck it, we gon' get them then. S-T-A, yes sir, that's the posse. Salam Nation PC, them brothers is my aunties. Better keep the peace or we'll blow like kamikazes. Gotta buy the light, make way for the mighty.
Man, peace. Once again, it's on. Another Lines Out the Cage blog talk radio production. No, this ain't no show. This is a production because we produce. This is a conversation because we communicate. Yeah, this is Lions Out the Cage. If you're scared, go to church because the nation can't use you. Lions Out the Cage, you are tuning in to a sucker-free zone and a hypocrite's worst nightmare. Lions Out the Cage. Keeping it 100 on the World Wide Web and 1,000 in the streets. Listen here. Lions Out the Cage. New York street sweepers. Yeah. Ain't no question. Look here, man. I don't know what y'all been told, but the Lions Out the Cage is mighty bold. I ain't no rapper. Look here, man. Look, I'm so fired up tonight. Listen, man, Sister Minister. I mean, I know the minister told us to call them labor students, right? And Minister Ava is definitely his student. But, man, if anybody qualifies themselves to be a minister outside of the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan, I mean, Minister Ava Muhammad is one of those ministers. So, but because we follow instructions, Student Minister Ava Muhammad on elevated places. Look, I'm almost kind of irritated, and I'm going to have a personal conversation. No, I ain't going to hate, because I don't think there was a better environment or opportunity for Brother Jay Electronica to show and prove his position in terms of Islam than in the environment that he was in. I mean, Lions Out the Cage is what it is, but all of us on Lines Out the Cage, we pretty much are tuned in on what's going on. I thank Allah for Jay Electronica and Wesley Muhammad, because they came in that environment with Sister Minister Ava Muhammad, and they represented the position that we have or we took in Brooklyn so magnificently. We are putting to bed all drama, mixed feelings, and controversy. Brother Jay Electronica was so humble, so very humble in how he broke down why he was wearing the FOI uniform. And when anybody can get up and bear witness of their own shortcomings, that is, like, to me, the biggest sign of being courageous than anything else. Do you know how many friends we employ? how many people we put on staff just to cover our madness? Do you know how many lies that we tell? Not only to other people, but to ourselves. To cover down or to put on this fig leaf, these holy robes. And I always said it, and we said it here in Lions Out the Cage, and we mean it. If you're wearing a holy robe, that only means we can see through you. Ain't nobody holy in this work. In fact, sometimes being holy in this world will put you at a disadvantage. Go think on that. You can be holy with Satan all you want. Righteous, Master Prophet Muhammad, the Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad, ain't never said that we should be holy. They said we should be righteous. Holy is anything that has not been tampered with or diluted in any form. So which one of us can stand up really and say we are holy? We will not be declared as holy until or unless Master Farad Muhammad makes all things new. We've already associated and interacted with this world to a certain degree that none of us can claim to be holy. And if you claim to be holy, like I say, it's like Swiss cheese holy. We can see right through you. So I praise Allah and thank him for Minister Ava, Dr. Wesley, and those individuals who are in control of the production, places production. Understand, we don't call none of these productions on Blog Talk shows because we ain't showing out. We try to keep it 100 on the World Wide Web and 1,000 in the streets. And sometimes that demonstration, by keeping it 100 on the World Wide Web and 1,000 in the street, sometimes it puts us in a bad predicament. Because what we put out ain't necessarily what we intend to be received. None of us know each other to the degree that we all should know each other. So we only can understand and receive each other based on our particular vantage point and our particular perception. The more we work this thing out and we continue to push Islam in the wilderness of North America, the more we will come into a greater understanding of who and what we are. And the brotherhood and the sisterhood will not be based on assumption and speculation, but on actual facts. That allows us to cover down on our brothers and sisters' weakness and demonstrate the true and living God in each and every one of us. Again, the stated purpose of the Allah team and the Lions Out the Cage is to create the most powerful brotherhood and sisterhood that has ever existed in this universe. This is not a stretch of the imagination. We don't think this is too much of a lofty goal. We really are convicted and determined with an idea to produce the most powerful brotherhood and sisterhood that ever existed. And the first step doing that is for us to step up out of these holy fig leaves that we use to cover ourselves, to shield our dirty religion. Listen here, man. My prayer, my sacrifice, my life and death is all for Allah. There is no associate that he has. You understand? To him, we do submit. So I don't give a damn how y'all view me. As long as I keep it 100 and 1,000, we good. Man, peace out to Wesley Muhammad. Peace out to Jay Electronica. Peace out to Student Minister Ava Muhammad. Peace out to the brothers and sisters who support the Elevated Places. We about to get it turned up. We dealing with the wounded soldiers. You know, I was just listening to the Minister Ava, and she was getting busy. And one thing she said that stuck out to me, amongst many things that she said and Dr. Wesley said, Jay Electronica said, is that we are at war. We are at war. Therefore, we must take on the posture of war. But we don't fight the way the devil fights. We fight the way Allah fights. We don't mimic the devil on how he fights. The thing that's going to throw the devil off, because he's wicked by nature, he can't comprehend a righteous fight. The thing that gives us an advantage is because we fight a righteous fight. Understand that righteous is not synonymous to weak. Some of us might think that humility and righteousness is a weak word, but in reality is the strongest of all words, because humility and righteousness allows us to reassess our position and attack our enemy at his or her weakest point. We are going to eliminate weakness because we are righteous. Man, don't it feel good to be on the winning team? Don't it feel good to claim Muhammad? Can you feel it? Do you feel it? Do you understand that it's 2 minutes left in the fourth quarter, it's our ball, and we got the defense winded because they thought that we gave up the fight? We called timeout. We drew up some plays, and now we're in a no-huddle offense, and we are dictating. We are in control of the defense. The defense is backpedaling. Praise be to Allah. Listen here, man. Defense wins championships. Praise be to Allah. So we are at war. So we're going to get into our program. But before we get into our program, to back what Minister Ava just got through saying, in terms of being at war, I want y'all to pay attention to this and really listen good.
I came here today to talk straight talk. I came here today not to pussyfoot around the truth. I came here today not to be a politician. I came here today not to use diplomatic language. I came to put my foot so deep into the behind of the weak and the wicked. And you will have to move my shoe leather out of your mouth to begin to speak again. Whether you know it or not, we are at war. Whether you know it or not, we are at war. Our survival as a people is at stake. And no weak-kneed, cowardly leaders need to stand in front of black people today. This is a time for real men. Men that understand that in order for people to be free, sacrifice has to be made. The loss of life has to take place. Blood must flow in order for people who are enslaved to be free. The time for talk is over.
Although, problem 13.
Now, let me say this. I don't know what was chopping up to you. And if it was chopping up when the minister was speaking, it's because we are, like, almost full capacity. I don't even know if people can get in. So if people are trying to get in, reach out to them and let them know. Get their phone numbers. And y'all can three-way individuals. Because y'all don't want to miss this production. You can three-way, get them on group conference call, because this is what happens when Islam takes its rightful position. Islam comes, as Jay Electronica and Minister Ava and Wesley so greatly articulated, when all else fails. We are the best thing that has happened to black America and black people all over the planet Earth. So at a certain point, you got to start feeling yourself. Not in a cocky, arrogant, I'm better than you, self-righteous type of way, but you got to understand that we are the number one team. And we should start demonstrating that. Now, I'm going to bring in Brother Marnef Muhammad before we bring in my good brother, Dr. Wesley Muhammad. I got to bring him in because this is my brother. He's broadcasting from an undisclosed location in the wilderness of North America. The F don't stand for fake, phony, or fraud, but he can sure be a fool with it, and he's certainly fed up. Now, we're going to do the best we can tonight because Dr. Wesley has already admonished us. Brother Rodney has already admonished us that we can't use certain language no more, and we understand that. But I want, with me and Brother Martin, we have a special message that we want to get out to our great sister, Minister Ava. And I want to bring him in. I'm going to let him do his thing. But then we really want to get serious, and we want to get into the meat of tonight's conversation. Because after tonight, we pledge that this struggle will never, ever be the same. It's almost like when white folk went to the moon and they planted the flag of the United States government on the moon. Some of y'all don't believe that happened. I feel you. But just deal with me for a minute. We are staking the flag into Black America and letting everybody know from this point on, Islam is back in the building and ain't going nowhere. And anybody who steps against Islam, we taking it personal. But we ain't here to fight nobody Black. We are to unify the nations. Allah builds himself up out of 10,000 parts, 10,000 philosophies, 10,000 different ideologies, and he declares himself as one. But after tonight, we ain't got no time to be slap boxing with brothers and sisters who do not see the united effort of Black folk and how powerful we are if we all settle on the best part. We are Islam fully locked and loaded and totally, completely, 100% off safety. Brother Martin, what's cracking, G?
Peace. Ain't nobody safe no more. We're totally off safety. I'm trying to tell you right now, I just got off the line listening to our brother, True Islam, Dr. Wesley Muhammad, engage in a great conversation with our hip-hop artist, good brother, humble brother, Jay Electronica, on Sister Minister Ava's radio show. If you missed that show, you missed a wonderful show. Jay Electronica has not done any interviews, but he blessed Sister Ava with that interview. Matter of fact, the world was blessed by having Brother Jay Electronica on Sister Ava's show. Now, let me get this straight. There's some kind of confusion going on to where the lion's out the cage, where it's being discussed in some circles among some of you who would be mischief makers, to have it as if you would try to pit the lions out the cage against our great sister, Minister Ava Muhammad. Let me get this straight right now. You ain't gonna do that. You can't do that. If I hear or see that you are even attempting to pit me against that one, that sister, who motivates me to be more every day, that motivates this particular movement that we're on, Islam locked and loaded, fully off safety, Ava Muhammad, you are having a problem with the lions out the cage. You can't do that. It was our great sister that moved us, Brother Philip A. Muhammad and Brother Martin F. Muhammad, to move to do more, to get up off our rusty dusty and get busy exercising problem number 31 out of the problem book. We came out of the cage listening to the Honorable Master Louis Farrakhan and subsequently listening to his national spokesperson, his national representative, Sister Minister Ava Muhammad. She is premier, from my estimation, presenting the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan. And one of the key things that I'm going to forever live with, and why we do what we do, and why you see what you're seeing that's on the rise today and what you just saw last weekend is because Sister Minister Ava said, listen to me clearly, that the time for teaching is up, and it's time for straight training. We are in training mode. And where are we training? We are training in the big fields. We are not playing house no more. We are not having church no more. Our people are tired. Our people are fed up. Our people are sick of being killed, murdered, maimed, distrusted, being busted, being disgusted. And it's time. Now that everything else has failed, as our brother Jay Electronica alluded to and brought out to everybody, that it's time for Islam after everything else fails. So you can't pit us against Sister Minister Ava. That's our great sister. And if you try it, man, Dr. Wesley, I'm telling you, brother, we have
well,
been,
let me say this because I don't want to say it. I don't want to sound and feel overly aggressive because that overly aggressiveness gets us in trouble. It recently came into my attention that me personally, I have this little thing that I do about beloved Muslims, and I say, you know, when the brothers and sisters, the brothers be like, Summer Lincoln, beloved. And I also have this thing when the brothers and sisters be singing the greetings. When you say, you see a brother or sister, you say, Assalamu alaikum, all that stuff. I heard brothers do that. And in the past, we was making light of that to prove a point that in the avenues and the streets that we in amongst our people, when we come across gangbangers and dope dealers and prostitutes and homeless people, that beloved Islamicum is not necessarily going to work with those people. It is not to make mockery of the brothers and sisters who use beloved. Islamicum, beloved. Minister Ava, Sister Minister Ava, she uses beloved all the time, but she's the mother of civilization. She's the black woman. I also hear Mother Tynetta Muhammad say it all the time. So when I speak on the beloved, by no means am I shooting anything, any darts or condemnation at the mothers of civilization. I am specifically talking about brothers who are in the community sweethearting with the thugs. That's a bad look in my estimation. Strength meets strength. The Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad said that every 25,000 years, the scientists get together and they write history in advance, and that one God's wisdom does not bow to an inferior wisdom, that the subsequent wisdom, the wisdom that is coming in the future, has to be greater than the wisdom that is present, lest the wisdom of the present will not bow down to the coming wisdom. And what I'm saying in the streets, by teaching the people and utilizing the people's language, we have to understand that the people that we are going to, they don't know what love feels like. They don't know what love feels like. They don't know what love looks like. Now, some may argue that you go to these brothers and sisters, and since they've been hated on, some of these children are crack babies. Some of these children are children that are the victim of incest or the result of incest. Many of our children, which is unfortunate, are the victims of rape, or their mother and father, their mother has been beaten by black men, been put on a whole stroll by black men. I'm talking about the worst of the worst. These young babies look like, in many instances, the father that have suppressed and oppressed the mother. And the mother, when they look at their baby, I've been in the position where my mother said, you're getting on my goddamn nerves. You look just like your daddy. Take your black ass to your room. Excuse my French. Let me make this point. I got to quote it the way my mama said it to me. Take your black ass to your room because you look just like your daddy. The tolerance level of some of our mothers in our community in regards to the children is low because the children look like the daddy and the daddy has victimized our babies. So when you come with love, sometimes our children are conditioned to reject that because a lot of evil, wicked behavior, nefarious activity within the house has been done and committed under the auspices of love. So what happens is, in my understanding, that we have to speak the people's language. See, we greet every registered Muslim in his or her own way. That means the language that we talk to the Muslims is somewhat different than the language we deploy in the streets. Love is a different thing when you're talking to a gangbanger. Love means something different when you're talking to a prostitute who is in the back seat of Johns and Tricks. And you come to them with that softness and a weakness, and you turn them off, but you think you turn them on. We have been turned upside down and inside out, and we don't understand what love looks like. So listen. Yes, 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 yes. Listen, unlike attracts and like repels, but a like language attracts. The difference thing is, listen, when you speak the same language, you draw people up to you. You keep them to you when they realize that it's deeper than the language, that the language might seem the same, but the heart is dramatically different. So you got to use the language to pull people into your current, into your cipher, because that's your magnetic communication bonds and communication severs. The proper communication allows you to pull people up into your orbit. But what keeps them there is your spirit and your love. So you use the language to pull on the heartstrings of your brothers and sisters, and then you use your wise ways and actions to keep them in your cipher. So you got to speak the language. It's like, what's the password? Can't nobody join a club, a gang, enter different areas or different societies, you know, secret societies within our community unless you know the password. What's the secret handshake? What's the secret knock? Then you get in there behind enemy lines and you show forth that you are different. So when I say it, about beloved Muslims, and some of you all ran off with it, and I didn't do an adequate job, I don't think, clarifying what I mean by that. In context is, brothers, it's time for you to get your weight up. It's time to get your chest poked out. You got to get your push-ups on. You got to get that strong jawline. You got to memorize your lessons by heart. You got to put on the full and complete armor of God and get in the community, and you meet force with force. Those black men and women in our community is not going to bow down to anything they perceive less than themselves. We have to meet them. Greater force and power, because our godship must be defended and it must be promoted. And those people in our community does not respect weakness. When we hear Mother Ava and Mother Tynetta, or Sister Ava, Minister Ava, and Mother Tynetta speak and they use beloved, that is the language of the Queen Mother. She can't get on there and say, "Salaamu Alaikum, soldiers. Peace, Lord." That sounds, we're not talking about the sisters. We're talking about the brothers who think you're going to come in there sweethearting thugs, killers, pimps, dope dealers, and gangbangers. I'm telling you from experience, we are undermining our power and our influence when we cannot get on the same vibration of our people and speak their language. So, if there was any misunderstanding to the Sister Queen, Mother Ava Muhammad, understand with all humility, my wife, I teach her the strength of Mother of a sister minister, Ava Muhammad, and I teach her the wisdom and knowledge I want her to get into Mother Tynetta Muhammad. I love both of these sisters, and I want my wife to be a reflection of both of those sisters. And if she was on the line, she'll tell you. So I apologize if there was any mixed feelings and controversy in that regard. Just let that be known. So as fast as you get in inboxes and emails and text messages and reports, bad news that really wasn't bad news, but it was rooted in faulty perception, I hope you all get on your jacks. Jacks is slang for phone. I hope you get on the inbox and your text message and let Sister Ava Muhammad know that the lions out the cage fully respect her. And if anything happens to Minister Ava, or anytime she needs soldiers to defend her, I swear to God, by Master Faraz Muhammad, that the Allah team and the Lions Out the Cage is going to grind you in the powder if you even think you're going to disrespect that black woman and any MGT who represents the brand, the Nation of Islam, and the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan. Brother Martin, do you have something to say before we bring Dr. Wesley in and we're going to get into this mighty, mighty conversation tonight?
I'm just a little disturbed that anybody would even attempt to try to bring up some type of confusion and get it twisted to where we have to come and explain ourselves in regard to our great sister, Ava Muhammad, who we listen to, who we strive to adhere to her great wisdom, and try to create confusion. That is a problem for me. And I pray to Allah that Sister Minister Ava would get this message, hear this message, and know that there's never nothing but love and the utmost respect for her in her whole entire representation and everything that she has ever been and ever done for the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan. So whoever you are that would take our message and misinterpret what we mean, you need to be ashamed of yourself. And I want to say to Sister Minister Ava, we love you with everything that we got, because you stand, you represent, and you defend the brand, and you defend the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan. And we will always stand with you. And we're not going to let no...
Careful.
None of the devil's imps confuse that and use us against our sisters to create confusion. Now, the theme of tonight's show is wounded.
It ain't
soldiers.
No show. It ain't no show, Brother Martin.
It ain't no show because we ain't on YouTube.
No, no, say it again. If you say show again, I'm muting you.
Well, that's the only power you got.
But well, that's enough power on this particular production.
If you mute me, I'm telling you, the lions out the cage is going to take a bite out of your ass.
See, you cussing. See, that's the thing. We promised Dr. Wesley that we would stop unnecessary cuss words. Now, you the first one to get on your apologies when you do something wrong.
Okay,
you
just
one to violate our oaths.
You just remember that when you do it. Sorry, Brother Wesley.
I'm not
going to
do it
no better.
Especially with Dr. Wesley on the line, because I don't want to argue with him. He ain't going to sit up and clown me because we use the word ASS and all that stuff. We got to stop that, Brother Martin. Have some discipline.
Look, you try, man, you remember you who's teaching now.
Man,
look,
I ain't scared of you, brother. I'm just telling you, stop it.
Listen, we are on a mission.
Here we go with
to make sure that Islam is resurrected in all of our communities, and that we spread it far and wide. We are locked and loaded and fully off safety. We are going to crisscross this country and make sure that we reach and teach and touch our people in the hood. The Allah team and the Lions Out the Cage are going to put on a proper demonstration of truth, love, and brotherhood, and build and grow the greatest brotherhood that there's ever been seen or known to man in the universe. This is not outside of our brotherhood that we have within the house, within the ranks of the Nation of Islam and Muhammad's mosque proper. Don't get it twisted, not for a second, you mischief makers. We are your brothers.
Right.
And we want to reach and teach those wounded soldiers, those brothers and sisters who have come into Muhammad's mosque at various times and went out for various reasons. Some of those who have went out didn't go out because they turned hypocrite. They didn't go out because they were upset because you didn't treat them right. Sometimes the atmosphere is not conducive to a particular individual, to a particular disposition, because the time might just not be right. We have to learn how to exercise and utilize the skills and capabilities of each one of our brothers and sisters to their fullest capacity, and we have to learn to respect one another with everything that we've been through. We have to learn to have patience with one another with everything we've been through, and we have to learn how to be a brother to our brothers and learn how to be a sister to our sisters.
Right.
And all in between. Y'all know what I mean.
Right.
So, some of us have been wounded. We've been hurt. We come into this teaching from various walks of life. We come in, some of us, as gangbangers. Some of us as prostitutes. Some of us as dope fiends. Some of us as drug dealers. Some of us come in as professionals. Some of us come in from very lofty homes and in high places. Some of us have been privileged. But at some point in time, there was a brother or sister, you know, somebody like a Minister Don, or a Minister Rockman, or a Minister Robert, or a Minister Tony, or a minister, what's the brother over in D.C.? Brother Kadir.
Brother Kadir.
Who's been rocking over on that East Coast in that region for such a long time. See, some of us came and we heard a word and we stood up on it, but the time might not have been right for our elevation at that particular time. Some of us have sticked. And we had to go and do other things. But the time is right now because the enemy is attacking us now more than he ever has been. Now, it was Sister Minister Ava who's pushing a hard line for separation. Why is she pushing that line? Because the Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad said that separation is the best and only solution. So we're raising that same tone coming out of the lines out the cage. We stand with our brothers, the Allah team, and we're pushing this line amongst our brothers and sisters in the streets that we must separate from our open enemy. The Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan illustrated as of recently that we need less litigation and we need more revolution. The definition of revolution is complete constructive change. That means we have to carry out a process from beginning to end. But in order to carry out a process from beginning to end, some of us have to begin. We got to get in the fight and stop punking out. So we're talking wounded soldiers. For whatever reason, but you ain't here with us on the battlefield. We calling you. Come link up with us. Come join on with us. Come back to your own. The Nation of Islam is in need of your service to go after all of our people. We stand with Allah, His Messenger, the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan, His National Spokesperson, Sister Minister Ava Muhammad, His Assistant, Helper, Brother Dr. Wesley Muhammad, a.k.a. True Islam with the Allah team, and we're going after all of our people. I'm done. I'm your brother Martin F. Muhammad, and I'm a lion out the cage.
And that's what I'm talking about. Let's bring him in, man. We know where this brother's at. We can't say the undisclosed location in the wilderness of North America. He's at Harold's Chicken, Starbucks, Lake Michigan. I mean, he let everybody know he's getting his fireworks on. I mean, I love my brother, but we know where. We definitely know where he at. Somewhere eating some chicken and drinking a caramel flan. Dr. Wesley Muhammad, what's good, True Islam?
Man.
You know, I told you I was going to get you. I told you. What up, G?
Look, man, I can't even be on here long because you got me messed up in the head because you got me thinking about FOI sweethearting with thugs. I can't even, like, move past that. That's
right.
A crazy image you put in my head, man. So you got me brain dead at this point.
Sorry.
Look, man, I'm honored to be back with the Lions
right.
Out the Cage, man. First, I want to say something about the Lions Out the Cage because y'all got me looking like the corporate censorer among us, trampling on y'all First Amendment rights, man. I got to clear that up. But first I want to just give a huge shout-out to Sister Minister Dr. Ava Muhammad and Jay Electronica. Man, some real history was made tonight.
Right.
Jay, folks have been getting at me with the understandable, legitimate request for Jay Elect to do an interview. That's the story that everybody rightfully wants. Now, he wasn't doing interviews since Brooklyn. He blessed all of us by surprising all of us, including myself, by honoring Dr. Ava's show with that first interview. And it's not an accident. It was Dr. Ava's show. Dr. Ava's Islam is the Islam that many of us who do this work the way we do respect the most. We respect her Islam infinitely. So, and Jay Elect's love for Sister Dr. Ava is, I'm sure, undergirds or is context to why Allah put it on his soul to call in and give that testimony that the God gave was phenomenal. And it's one of the best testimonies I've heard. And in fact, that testimony for me, the real story here, Brooklyn was a setup for his testimony on Dr. Ava's show. Brooklyn,
right.
The Brooklyn demonstration was the backdrop for a real point was that Black God's testimony. But let me say this, man. Y'all keep clowning me about this custom. Let me defend my brand. But let me say this about, let's be real clear about the Lions Out the Cage. From my perspective, I want everybody to understand why it is that I, Dr. Wesley Muhammad, rode with the Lions Out the Cage like I do. I do not. The Lions Out the Cage are one of the most important maneuvers of Islam going on today. The work that the Lions of the LOTC are doing, in the particular way that the LOTC doing it, is one of the most important works being done for Islam on the planet right now, in my opinion, my genuine, honest opinion. Now, as I tell everybody, because I get called all the time about these folks, I'm about to, you know how Malcolm X gave that press conference when he was separating from the Nation of Islam? I'm a call or two away from giving a press conference announcing my separation from the LOTC. But I'm dealing with y'all madness. I get it all day. But I want to, LOTC's way is vitally important. Their way of doing their particular work is critical. Their work is critical, but the way they do their work is critical. They, in fact, cannot do the important work that they are doing if they change their way. They could do it, but they would not be effective. Let's be real clear. The LOTC's reach, the field that the LOTC works in, is a restricted field. The field that Dr. Wesley Muhammad works in is a restricted field. The only one that I know whose field and success in that field is unrestricted is the Honorable Mr. Louis Farrakhan. He can walk in any field and be effective. None of us under him can claim that. All of us who are doing any work, and if we are doing any work and having any measure of success, the field that we are working in and the field that we have success in is restricted. And our success is based on our successfully working in that specific field. And with the LOTC, the work that they are doing in the specific field and being so successful, and it's a work and success that is one of the most important going on for Islam right now in America, and thus on the planet. The work, the field that they are working in, if they did not do it in their particular way, they would not be successful. All who want the LOTC to switch methods, you are asking them to trade success for failure in their particular field. And all of you who have suggestions about how they could better do their work, you cannot get in the field that they are working in with success and do it with your suggestions and be successful. I know that for a fact. Now, will the LOTC get everybody with their particular method? No, but you ain't getting everybody with your particular method. I'm not getting everybody with my particular method. There's only one who's speaking, who's successfully speaking a universal language. That's Farrakhan. All of us, we're speaking our dialect in our areas of the world. Some of us are successful. Most of us are not. The LOTC are successful. So I want to put it out that I rise with, and more often than not these days, for the LOTC, because their work is of critical value. There's few works that I'm witnessing that are more valuable than the work the LOTC are doing it. And they have to do it
in the way they are doing it. So I resist all urging for the LOTC to switch lanes, to switch methods. No. Now, what I do build with my brothers on. Sometimes, you know, we are all learning the penalty, the cost of elevation. There's a cost of elevation. When we working, when we doing what we do in the basement, you know, in between doing what we do, we can shoot craps or whatever. But whatever we do, we in the basement. We can say it how we want to say it. We can do it how we want to do it. But we dreaming about doing what we do on the roof, up top, where everyone can see us. Well, there's a cost to that. And so we not in the basement anymore. The LOTC, they ain't in the basement no more. They on rooftop. LOTC got the ear and the eye of the streets, but also of the heavens, if you will. And the issue is, and our challenge, my challenge, all of our challenge is to be strong with dignity, right? To be muscle, have our representation, our demonstration, a demonstration of real muscle, and the God, Philip, is right. In the fields we need to be working in, it requires muscle. Ain't no sweethearting in those fields. And the reason in these particular ciphers the nation has lost respect is because the nation's muscles got flabby, at least in the eyes of those who lost respect for us. Our muscles got flabby. And so muscle is necessary. And I love the muscle of the LOTC. It's a muscle that's needed. It's a muscle that's effective. Now, the challenge is to do muscle with dignity. Right? So we all have to take it up a notch. In our elevation, the cost of it is, you know, dignity was always a good thing to have in a basement, but it ain't necessary. But the higher we go up, our muscle must be matched with dignity. And so, I don't say all that to say to clear my name from these false, scandalous charges of Brother Philip and Brother Martin. I don't try to. I don't try to get them out of their orbit. No. We got to tone it down, some of the language, but their muscle is necessary, and their muscle is a good look for our brand. And it's I'm going to say this. In the relatively short time the LOTC has been doing their work, the way they do it, with that muscle, in that short time, they've already turned years of weakness that we have accrued. In that short time, they've overturned and turned back in the eyes of a great segment of the community years of weakness and flabbiness that the community has seen us with. So, yeah, man, I'm not. Don't let them fool you. I'm not trying to censor them, but we're all trying to grow. They helped me grow in my representation, and I try to help them grow so I can stop taking calls on their behalf, talking all day on their behalf. It gets tiring, man. I don't want to do that no more. So shut up. Stand down. Calm down so I can get some work done. Nah. But for real, I don't want, and none of us should want, the LOTC to do the work they're doing in any other way than the way they are doing it. Yes, can we be more refined in our representation? Yeah, we could. But you ask them to not do what they do the way they do it, your request is not in the best interest of Islam.
Man. That's now love. Peace, Brother Dr. Wesley. That's a real testimony right now. You almost made Brother Martin cry. Go ahead, Brother Martin.
You speaking on my tears. Look, that's real talk, Brother Wesley. We appreciate you, and I'm sorry, brother, that we make you go through all that you go through trying to defend us. But
no,
that's brotherhood. That's love. Y'all worked it.
Y'all I ain't worked. Sorry. He got to do something.
Yeah, I know.
Give
yeah,
back.
I know.
Give back.
This dude.
I mean, sorry. He supposed to. Praise be to Allah. That's the brotherhood. The brotherhood comes with responsibility. Go ahead,
it's
brother.
It's
amazing work out here in this big field. Now, this is what I want. We're going into dealing, Dr. Wesley and Brother Phillip, with the wounded soldier tonight, and I want to get deep into this subject because it's a major one. Now, Brother Phillip, I want you and Brother Phillip and Dr. Wesley to open that up, but if you got 4954 lit up on that phone line, I need you to let that piece in. And
you said what number?
4954, something like that. Hold on.
Well, he got to push one on whoever it is. He's got to push one on the keypad.
4954. Yeah.
4954.
Push one on your keypad, and we and I want y'all to introduce what we mean tonight when we're talking about that wounded soldier.
All right. So whoever that is got to push one. I don't see it right now. We got brother Rodney on the switchboards, and he don't see it either. So whoever that is, push one, and we'll get to it. And I'm going to open up right now with what we mean by wounded. You know, it's not easy working with black people. And in instruction number two that's given to us by our Savior, Master Prophet Muhammad, it says that each student must qualify him or herself for positions awaiting them. Assignment of office will be made immediately after examination and completion of his or her labor course. Examination, anything that says T-I-O-N means process. Anything, any word that has T-I-O-N, shun, that's a process that we go through to become qualified. Examination, exam means to look into, to uncover, to discover. Exam, it also means to be tested. Each one of us are being tested. And it is through that testing that we reveal ourselves to ourselves. And in understanding and testing ourselves, we uncover what position we will be playing in recovering our people. Many times, if we don't understand the examination, the process of exam, and what is the purpose of examination, many times we become a little bit defiant towards a process that Master Farad Muhammad, Allah in person, originated. Sometimes that which we hate most is that which is qualifying us for our position. So many times, because we don't understand, we think we come to Islam and we think it's supposed to be a smooth sailing. I said it a couple of days ago. I've seen clean deaths. People who have a heart attack, drop dead. People who have an aneurysm, drop dead. Clean deaths. People die in their sleep. Drop dead. I ain't never, ever, 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 ever seen of nor heard of a clean birth. Never. There's always some mixed feelings and controversy. There's always some pain and some screaming and some nervousness. When the baby comes out, the baby might be blue. The umbilical cord might be wrapped around the baby's neck. There might be an emergency C-section. There's screaming. There's trauma when you bring life. But there's been deaths that don't receive that much trauma, that don't indicate so much trauma. There has never been a clean birth. So if any of us think that we're going to come into our godhood and it's going to be clean and it's not going to require blood and mess and trauma and mixed feelings and controversy, then we don't necessarily understand what this is about. If we get into this thinking that we are not going to take on stripes and scars and wounds, then we don't fully understand. But some of us have a religious mindset, and we have to bust that up and understand that the process of Islam is sometimes messy. Doesn't the Quran say when he creates a new man and he tells the angels to bow down, are you going to create something that spreads mischief and bloodshed? while we exalt thy praise and extol thy might, thy majesty? Surely I know what you know not. Pain, blood, drama, mixed feelings, controversy, chaos, not confusion, is the order of the day in order to create God. It is not easy dealing with black people, especially when we can't take black people and put them on an island somewhere. We can't take black people and take them into the jungles of West Asia. We can't put them somewhere. See, everything we're doing is done with white people in offense. We can't go on an island somewhere and just keep white folks roped off where we deal with the process of uplifting black people like Musa did in the cave. It was very easy for Musa to keep outside interference. He had to deal with a savage. A savage is a person who has lost the knowledge of themselves and who is living a beast life. He had to deal specifically with a savage mentality. Now, he had a hard time. But the hardest of all times is when Muhammad is given the mission to raise the black man and woman in America. That is the hardest job ever given to any man, including Musa. It is because while we're creating man and we're creating woman and we're raising them up into their godhood, we have interference by the devil. The devil is coming inside of the mob and inside of the ranks in black skin. Satan is participating in an avatarian experience. It is an out-of-body experience because Satan is a mentality that jumps into the body of black men and black women. You understand? So the check has to be on at the door. My point is this, brothers and sisters. Don't hate the process that's going to make you great. Stop wringing your hands and hating the God that's going to bring you out of life, out of death into life. It is time, right now, when the Allah team and the Lions Out the Cage steps your place, it is to take the bullet. We are willing to absorb all of the darts, the arrows, the swords in our back, the knives in our back, the backbiting, because we love the believers. We've been through it all. We've been hated on. We've violated the restrictive law. We've been put out the mosque. We've been doing stuff. We thank Allah for not being put out or not being discovered for some of the evil or wicked things we might be doing. We represent. Listen, the Quran says it like this. If we don't do what we're supposed to do, Allah will remove us and replace us with a people that is mighty against the disbeliever and humble towards the believer. That this particular people will not feel the fear, the censor of any censorer. We won't worry about what they say about our speech because we're mighty against the disbeliever. And if we're mighty against the disbeliever, we 100 times more mightier against the hypocrite. But we also are humble to the believer. So for the brothers and sisters, know this by Allah. Understand that this is true. There are some, and I wish that you guys go in. I don't know when the recast is going to be available for Minister Ava's show tonight, her production tonight. But you really need to listen to it and understand the testimony of Brother Jay Electronica. He came out in front of the world with the humble spirit to testify about his particular struggle. None of us are without sin. And we have to be able to now tell the truth because the day of judgment means this. It means when everything begins to tell the truth about itself. The day of judgment is also the manifestation of defects. It is also the day of treachery and betrayal. So if Allah manifests your defects, don't get mad. Clean it up. He is showing you our defects so we can go to work on it. So it is time for all the brothers and sisters who have been hurt, who have not been given the just due, who have not been shown appreciation, who have been burnt out, who have not been given the benefit of the doubt, who maybe have been falling underneath misjudgment or wicked speculation. Maybe you have been a victim of slander and backbite. Maybe you have given all of your time. You've lost your husband. You lost your wife. You lost your mother, your father, your sisters, your cousins. Your family has rejected you because of your walk in Islam. At this point, Islam is locked and loaded, fully off safety, and we want to let you know it is now safe for you to come out come out and tend to your wounds without the wolves devouring you. They're lions out the cage. The Allah team, the brand, the sisterhood, the brotherhood got your back. So come on out and let's go to the hospital and let's get this mighty work cracking because it's about that time.
Now listen, let me say this in regards to that. We told y'all that Islam is locked and loaded fully off safety. You just heard our brother Jay Electronica. You saw our brother Jay Electronica. All of you who got the Final Call newspaper, you see the illustration from the demonstration that was put on by our brother Jay Electronica. But let me say this very clearly, that in 2014, the Nation of Islam has been blessed with a brother to represent and put on for our nation, for the world. But that brother could not put on for the nation and the world had he not been standing on the shoulders of brothers who came before him, who represented and put on for our nation. I'm talking about soldiers like Brother Cam. Not Cameron from that East Coast, that pink-wearing furry dude. I'm talking about OG West Coast Cam. Straight out of that Watts, California, that has been pushing the line for Islam and the Nation of Islam and the fruit of Islam since his inception as being a hip-hop artist. This brother has told the lie and has...
Can I do this? Can I do this, Brother Martin?
Get it
when
in.
When you finish your point, when you finish your point, I got something. So go ahead and finish your point. Go ahead, brother.
This brother has told the lie and has suffered at the hands of the open enemy who controls hip-hop. Get the book, The Hip-Hop Nation, Willie Lynch's Newest Slave. Brother Philip tells you who's in control of this thing. But they have devastatingly affected our brother and his ability to reach to the capacity he can reach. But by the grace of Allah, he done touched many of us. And that's the reason why you had the lions out the cage today, because myself, Brother Martin F. Muhammad, Brother Philip A. Muhammad, and many, many of you across these airwaves heard our brother OG Cam out of the West Coast represent and put on for our nation. And that's why you have a Jay Electronica today, because there was forerunners before him. We cannot forget that brother who also fell in the ranks, suited and booted, Farrakhan recruited, brother Professor Griff, the Minister of Information for that prolific group, Public Enemy. He is that one out of the group who was and is FOI, Fruit of Islam, and who represented and put on for our nation. And we have a Jay Electronica today because those brothers stood. And as you heard in the beginning of the show, you heard our little brothers, our young brothers.
Right.
The Mom Nation coming out of Los Angeles, Compton, California.
Which is the family of Cam.
These are the nephews. One of them is the nephew of our great brother Cam, and they put on to a Public Enemy beat. See, there's future, there's little cubs, there's babies being raised in this hip-hop thing. Hip-hop has the ear of our babies, and our babies are taking hip-hop and giving it back to the world. So we got to give all love and all due respect to OG brother Cam. So we got to give all respect to brother Professor Griff.
Just to get a foot up in the world, niggas will try to fit.
As soon as you're ready, Brother Martin, here we go.
Get it in.
Just to get a foot up in the world, niggas that try to fit. Since I won't sell out for nada, I gotta put up with a lot of shit. Politics, lawmakers, fakers and hypocrites, family even trip a bit. Man, we take a grip of shit. While many say that I'm too hard and such, I just forgive and forget, take plenty shit and pardon much. Come through in the clutch when niggas is in disparity. I breaks bread with them and just write it off as charity. But apparently some people don't understand it, cause they try to run game and pitch to me underhanded. Man, don't think I don't know you just because I keep my mouth shut. Yeah, I got a kind heart, but take a mile, so now I don't even flinch. I just bow, fake a smile, shake their hand, cause I done suffered too much damage for my blindness. Let niggas manage to take advantage of my kindness, therefore I can't speak about too much on the personal. Niggas know I ain't weak, it's just sometimes I'm too merciful, and it hurts to know that people so evil deep down inside, that it make me wanna just go pick up the 4-pound and ride. Niggas is already skeezed up my squeeze eye. The only reason, man, some niggas ain't dead, I'm trying to please God. And to y'all females with all of y'all devices who think that I might trick cause of my niceness. Than a serpent, more humble than a dove. Man, I don't ride for the money, I rumble for the love, the brotherhood, truth, freedom, justice, and equality. Cause see them youth, today ain't no busting. So man, I gotta be all the way real, all the way right, and fight the fight with all of my zeal and all of my might. Shine my light of knowledge of self on them with respect, to put my black peoples back on top and these crackers in check. In spite of they steady hating, I always been nice, even though y'all already skating on thin ice. My advice to y'all who don't think that we recognize your disguise, cause we act civilized.
Man, that's so thorough. 4954. Brother Martin said I need to open this up. 4954. Don't take our kindness for weakness. You're going to mess around and get it twisted. 4954. Lines out the cage. What you got for the gods?
Man, if that's 4954 and the line is open up, I'm trying to tell y'all, when we say the wounded soldier and we say Islam is locked and loaded and fully off safety, see, we deal with the industry cats, but don't get it twisted. We might deal with the industry, but we in the streets.
Man, so who is this? 4954.
Go ahead, brother.
Come on, man.
Walik Salam.
Oh yeah, I'm online. Brother Warren 2X out on the headquarters, Chicago.
The Great Warren?
Oh, man, just your brother, that's all.
Praise be to a lot of top fishermen in the nation.
Peace to the
Islam.
God, Brother Warren.
It's good to hear you, Brother Mark, Brother Warren. Peace, Lord.
Amen. And peace to you, brothers, man. I've been on since before it started. I've been on. This is the first time I've ever heard you, brother. But you are definitely an asset to the Nation of Islam. And anybody who sees it any other way is nothing more than an agent provocateur.
Right.
Of the progress of our people. Because it didn't take me but 2 minutes to realize that you're an asset. And anybody else who sees you any different, brother, they say headquarters is honeycombed with hypocrites. And the minister said,
you said it, not me.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, I ain't said that. You said that, Brother Warren.
Yes, sir. I didn't say I said it. I said the messenger said.
Yes, he did.
Yes, that is honeycomb with hypocrites. And the minister said, if I knew who the hypocrite was, don't you know I would have cut their head off by now?
Right.
So brother, you keep doing what you're doing, brother. because I am one of the lions out the cage.
Praise to Allah.
Yes, sir.
I am one of them, brother. You know, and this it's sweat, blood, and tears in this, brother. It's sweat and blood and tears. These Europeans didn't come over here with clean faces and moose in their hair and suit and ties on.
Right.
They came over here killing Indians and enslaving Negroes.
Right.
And they just modified it. I just did 27 months in the county jail. I just did 27 months on some trumped up charges and had two bootleg attorneys represent me for the first year. I fired them attorneys and ordered the books and studied myself, and now I'm home.
Praise be to Allah.
All praises be to Allah. Because we have to try our God today, brother. We have to try him.
Oh, indeed. Oh, yes, sir.
See, yes, sir. Because the messenger said we don't need no scared to death Negroes on our team no more. We need boots in the street. We need boots on the ground. And that's exactly what you all are doing. And believe me, I've been doing that up here for many moons since I've been out the belly of the beast in 03. But this is what we need, brother. What y'all are doing, what I see with you all in the final call with Jay Electronica, man, this is what we need, brother. All this preaching in the mosque and all this preaching, the message said 10% of the work is at the podium. 90% is in the street.
That's right. Real talk.
And if any brother that's in the mosque preaching at the podium, that's 10%. How good are they in the street, brother? What is their grade in
good
the street?
Talk.
You see what
real,
I'm saying?
Good,
what
good,
is your grade
question.
In the street? See, a leader is defined by its followers, brother.
Yes, sir.
And every follower that comes in Mars Maryam and all these other Mars, them the minister's followers, brother.
That's right.
Then if the minister took his followers away, what would all these brothers who sitting at the podium be? Where would your followers be? Because you don't go in the street to get the people. And when brothers
real
like
talk.
Me go out there to get the people, when we go out there and get the people, we got more controversy in the mosque than we do in the street.
Real talk. Real
What's
talk.
What's wrong with this?
That's
an ugly picture, brother. But you know what? That's what I love about Lions Out the Cage.
Go ahead.
Because you brothers get out in the street and do what you got to do, despite controversy, despite the biggest fight being in the mosque, brother.
Yes, sir.
You know, when I was in the belly of the beast, brother, in 27 months, brother, the work didn't stop because I was there, brother. The fruit of Islam represents a seed. So if you plant the brothers in the belly of the beast, guess what? You planted a seed. And the seed sends down a root down and it shoots up. And we're going to bloom where we planted. And that's exactly what happened. I went in there and went to all the bullpens. Whenever they sent me to court, I was shushing the brothers in there and keep putting that teaching of the Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad on them brothers. And let them brothers know that, brother, you in bondage, talking about you in a county jail. Brother, you in slavery. Don't you know the 13th Amendment means slavery nor involuntary servitude shall exist in America except as a punishment for a crime? You're not in the county jail. You're not going to state jail. You're not going to Menard. Brother, you in slavery, brother.
Right.
I gave them flyers, brother. I made flyers and gave them to all the brothers all across the county jail and told them, brother, don't ever say you in the county or you in jail. You in slavery. Welcome to modern day slavery.
Man.
See, these, once,
praise
once
belongs
once,
to Allah.
Yes, sir. Oh, praises be to Allah. These are the things
praise
that we got to do. But, brother, y'all going to be in Philadelphia on the 8th and the 9th. You know,
yes,
I had a little breakdown with my car, but, you know, I had a crash. But, inshallah, brother, I'm going to get down there to Philly with y'all, brother. And
praise belongs to Allah. We're glad that it was only your car that had a breakdown in that crash and not your sister. Praise be to Allah.
Thank you, brother.
Go ahead, brother.
Wrap up.
If I could just touch on something real quick. When we talk about wounded soldiers, I think it's imperative that we are clear about who or what's doing the wounding of these soldiers. It's not that. Let's be real clear. It's not that
we laborers. I'm a laborer. I'm a national laborer. It is. So I have put, it's not that we laborers are what's doing the wounding. The laborers, it's not the laborers of the mob that's doing the wounding. It's the culture that has taken hold in the mosque that's doing the wounding. So that culture is made manifest by laborers and rank and file alike. It's a particular cultural cancer that is doing the wounding. So the problem that we face in the mosque, the problem is not the laborers. The problem is not the bureaucracy. The problem is the culture. Well, I want to say, give a big shout out. There's too often in our discourse, mine and Brother Phillips and Brother Martins and others, we are not as tidy, if you will, with our language, and we give a mistaken and potentially damaging impression that we don't recognize the work and the sacrifice that those who labor in this work have made in the course of their labor. All workers in this cause, the laborers, Farrakhan's laborers,
yeah,
they've had to sacrifice to do their labor. And they did their labor. They were tasked, our task, with the duty of laboring among the people that the scripture describes as snakes and scorpions. That is what we have become in the mosque and out of the mosque. And so I would never want to trivialize the enormous work and sacrifice of the laborers, those of the likes of student minister Rodney Muhammad and others. I love them all. In all of their labor, Allah waits not the work of a worker. The problem that has me disgruntled as a Muslim, that has me wounded as a Muslim, is not a problem of laborers. It's a problem that engulfs laborers and non-laborers alike. It's a culture that has taken root in our nation, a culture that wounds.
Right.
And if I can cite an example, I hope my brother does not take offense to me citing him as an example, but I think it's such a pertinent example. My brother, Jason C. Muhammad, a Farrakhan factor. Look, Jay Electronica, I think, is listening. He'll tell you, over maybe two decades ago, that brother Jason Muhammad, a Farrakhan factor, in my house with Jay Electronica and another brother, with my wife at the time and my baby, and we chopped it up in good brotherhood. Man, to this day I remember that weekend we went to, you know, these Muslims, these supreme wisdom scientists. Spent our time. We went to University of Michigan Library, put up the microfiche to find that 1932, the original of that 1932 photo, Detroit Free Press photo of Master Farrakhan Muhammad. And we found it. Me, Jay Electronica, Jason C. Muhammad, we found it. It was good times. It was good for us. And, of course, we know Brother Jason was wounded in the mosque. And he fell out. People
will come on Farrakhan's factor, who are enemies of Farrakhan, and do what they do. And people took Brother Jason to be, to have turned hypocrite. I never did. And a time came, Brother Jason is listening. So he remembers this. A time came where there's some misunderstanding, and Brother Jason and I on Farrakhan's factor, you know, we slapped Fox. Nothing too serious. We just slapped Fox. So we didn't debate or none of that. We just did a little slap Fox. We haven't spoken to each other probably since right after he had left my home. When we slapped Fox because of a misunderstanding on Farrakhan's factor, one of the things he said was, he assumed I saw him as a hypocrite. And what I said to him publicly then is, well, and it's the point of this anecdote, I said, Brother Jason, I never not only called you a hypocrite, but I never even thought of you as a hypocrite, because even though I don't know whatever it is that took you from the mosque, I personally know a million legitimate reasons why somebody would leave the mosque. I know a million legitimate reasons why somebody would fall out of the mosque. Having been in this for over 20 years, seen what I've seen, experienced what I experienced, know what I know about this life, that I never would and never could call you a hypocrite because you left the mosque, because I know there are a million legitimate reasons why one would leave the mosque. And I was blessed maybe last month to meet my brother, Jason Muhammad, at Starbucks, and we chopped it up, and it was a good time, and that sit down, proved my hesitation to be correct, that he was never a hypocrite, but he was a wounded soldier, a wounded believer. And I say that to say, we throw the title hypocrite around way too much. And the fact of the matter is, most who come into the mosque, if they are ill-treated, if we are ill-treated and leave, most don't become hypocrites, public enemies of Farrakhan or the nation. Some do, but most don't. And so to most who leave because of ill treatment, they're wounded by that treatment. And to heap the stigma of hypocrite on them is to further wound them. We are doing to our wounded soldiers what America does through the VA to her wounded soldiers. We're pouring salt on their wound, and we should never do that. So the fact of the matter is, when we say wounded soldiers, it is those who are wounded by the culture that we have allowed to grow up in a very damaging culture. And the people, believers, are wounded by it and leave it, and we are saying that, our battle, because a lot of teams and LOTC, you see us, we stay in battle. We stay in battle with external enemies of Islam and internal enemies of Islam. But let's be real clear, there's only one internal enemy of Islam, and that's the degenerate culture, the un-Islamic culture that we are all guilty of. We are at war with individuals or institutions in our nation. We are at war with the culture, the degenerate culture of the mosque that wounds the believers and sends them out of the mosque to be further wounded. We war with that culture unapologetically. And we are calling, we are trying to signal to the wounded soldiers out there, we got you. We got you. You can't come back home because we determined that we're going to do our part to clean this mess up. And let it be known, the only person that can stop us in this war against the degenerate culture that has taken root in our minds, the only person that can stop it is the Honorable Mr. Louis Farrakhan, and having had the honor to sit with him at his table on multiple occasions over these last 2 years, I am absolutely convinced he ain't stopping that, because he is waging war with that culture. He feels of this culture how we feel of this culture. He is, in his way, wounded by this culture because he is wounded. He feels our. He vicariously suffers as we suffer, as believers suffer. So the wounds that the believers suffer because of this culture, he suffers. So I have absolutely no fear that the one and only person who can stop this war we're engaged in will have no interest in stopping this war that we are engaged in. We just got to do it in a way that represents
just
him and his spirit.
Right. Yeah, peace, Brother Dr. Wesley, and that's real stuff. In our prayer, we say, you know, that we have been greatly unjust to ourselves, and we do confess our faults. So if we're going to be greatly unjust to ourselves, and we know we got to confess our faults, if we ain't doing right by ourselves, we know somebody outside of ourselves don't stand a chance. So we have to ask the Lord to forgive us and to bless us and protect us against our faults, against ourselves. Then maybe we should also ask Allah to bless us and to give us the insight to treat each other the way we should be treated. That's a beautiful thing.
Just a footnote, I don't know if I made it clear. Jason C. Muhammad, what was revealed is he was never a hypocrite. He was always a believer. And he is a believer to this day. Peace, Brother
Jason.
Right. I love you, beloved.
And that's real. Let's be careful, man, because again, if some of us, our inbox on Facebook was revealed to some of us, it would devastate us. Not to mention our dirty laundry. So let's keep it 100. If we focus on ourselves enough, you know, some of y'all want to judge Brother Warren. Some of you all judge Wesley. Some of you all judge Martin, myself, and everybody on the line. Look here, man. Look here. If we get knocked down and we stand up, that should show you something. Praise be to Allah. And if we get down and we stand back up, it is our duty for the brotherhood, it is the duty for the sisterhood that we extend our hand to our brothers and sisters and help them get up too. We should not take joy, any pleasure, when we see a brother or sister getting marched out of the nation. We follow instructions. We do what we have to do in terms of our rules and our protocol. But if anybody has a smile on their face when they see one of us get marched out, then we do not share the same spirit of Master Farad Muhammad. Let's open
and
this
they
line
are part
up,
of
man.
That culture that I'm talking about.
That's
part
right.
Of that
praise.
Degenerate culture that is the problem.
And we're going to fix it by the grace of Allah. We are going to burden everybody with our love. So if y'all don't like love, you ain't going
to
hate. You're going
to
hate on us. We're going
to
overwhelm you with our love. It ain't no punk love. It ain't no sissy love. It's the brotherhood and the sisterhood. And we're going to flood you with it. So the hypocrite don't even feel, they don't feel secure in love. So praise
you
be God. Let's get this line cracking. Brother Warren, you still on the line, brother. So don't even trip, because somebody might ask you a question, brother. Your line is wide open. So, but we're going to go to 0191. Let's keep this moving. We got 20 minutes. Let's try to hit as many as we can. Peace. 0191. Go ahead. 0191. I'm only going to give you 3 seconds. 0191. Lines out the cage.
0191, you got to take your phone off mute. Everybody else, pay attention. When you get online, you got to take your line off mute. Go to the next call. We not waiting.
6429, lines out the cage. 6429, lines out the cage. Come on now. Take your phone off mute.
Man, we acting slow. I know we got plenty of calls coming in. Go to the next call.
8372, line it out the cage.
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa
alaikum salam.
Peace, brother. So this is Sister Stacy Muhammad in Brooklyn, New York.
How are you, Sister Stacy?
I don't know how I am. You know, I got the flyer on Facebook today, and I wanted to call in, not quite sure what I would say, except that I don't want to be in the mosque. You know, there's an air of something in the nation that's very disturbing. It's a repulsive arrogance, and I hope you all take my words and the spirit in which they're intended. Everything that Brother Wesley said was right on point in terms of the ways in which we use the word hypocrite too easily and too quickly to condemn people that have been hurt. I came into the nation at the age of 21 after going through what young black women go through in this world. And I came to the nation because I was a young Muslim woman and I wanted to be somewhere where I would be safe. And I didn't have the discipline to secure myself. And my expectation was that the people in positions of leadership would be spiritually mature enough to secure me, and they were not. Myself, Brother Zahir Ali, worked at the Million Man March headquarters with Minister Farrakhan.
Yes, my brother Zahir.
Yes, sir, Brother Zahir. Yes. And with Brother Benjamin Chavis. I won't even go into the things that have happened in the nation. I take responsibility for the things that I've gone through. But, you know, there's just this air of arrogance that exists. There are a lot of people that have
been hurt. That is right.
You know, I feel like we're lectured to a lot and the believers aren't listened to enough. Every time I hear the word hypocrite, I cringe because I don't think
I do too.
Enough
yes,
people really understand that people come to the Nation of Islam, I think, primarily to find hope. I'm away from my home. You know, I've done a lot of work since I've been out of the nation. And Minister Farrakhan said to me personally years ago, go to school, finish school, go do the work. I need to have people who know more and who want to know more than just where the mother plane is going to land. We need engineers, yes. We need filmmakers, we need artists. And those are the things that myself, and those are the things that Zahir Ali, who is not active in the Nation of Islam, but is a brilliant brother. I just don't think
yes,
that
he is.
Yet.
I know his story.
Yet the caliber of believer that's not in the mosque. So I don't really know what I want to say except that we're here.
No, you said
we're,
it.
We're working. I'm honest about not wanting to be there, but it hurts my heart to not be there. That's it.
You know, you. If I can, just quickly, and then Brother Phil and Brother Martin, you said the precise words I think you should have said.
Yes,
you
sir.
Said... it all. I feel your wound and you're speaking of the culture that I'm speaking of. The reason you don't want to be in the mosque is because that culture is in the mosque. What you described are the manifestations in terms of your encounter in the mosque. It's the very culture that I'm speaking of. And I know Brother Zahir and peace, Brother Zahir, and your larger point is absolutely correct of brilliant Muslims that can be such wonderful assets to this nation, run out of the nation, not just by laborers, but by fellow rank and file believers, by the culture. And anybody can be the incarnation or representative of that culture at any given moment. It could be the minister. It could be the captain. It could be the secretary. It could just be the brother or sister. Any and all of us have, regardless of our rank, have been representatives of that culture. But I want to give you this good news, Sister
Vicky. Yes,
you said you don't want to be in the mosque.
what you do. What I tell people, what my soapbox preaching is today, and this is the work of this undergirds the work of the LOTC and the ALL team. In 2014 and going forward, Islam is no longer mosque centric.
Mm-hmm.
Let me make that clear and explain what I mean by that.
Mm-hmm.
We work in the field. It's a field mosque. Now, the mosque, the physical mosque, would always have its place and its value. That's why we don't abandon it. We don't leave it. We're in there fighting to uproot that culture that you spoke of so that place can serve the purpose for every single one of us that it's supposed to serve as our staging grounds to go out and get our people. We're not supposed to spend most of our time there anyway.
Mm-hmm.
The minister has told us. We go there to recharge and then get out. But the message I want to get, the good news that I try to give to all wounded soldiers that I come in contact with who want to be back in the quote-unquote mosque, but don't want to reopen the wounds that sent them out in the first place. Look, you good. The mosque is where you at. You ain't got to come to the physical mosque no more to do your Islam in a communal way.
Mm-hmm.
You don't have to go to the physical mosque to be a part of the communal mosque no more, because we are working hard to erect the field mosque.
Mm-hmm.
So whether you ever set foot in the mosque that you got registered in again or not, you can still be part of the community of Islam. Now, again, that is not to say, I want to be real clear. The Honorable Mr. Louis Farrakhan said that the Honorable Elijah Muhammad said that the mosque was never set up to be a mass movement.
Mm-hmm.
All black people weren't going to be in the mosque. The mosque can't accommodate all black people. The mosque was only going to be the vanguard for black people.
Mm-hmm.
The gods over who rule over the black nation. The Islam, however, it's a beat throughout the black nation, mosque and mosque. So the point is, it's okay that right now, next year, you are not compelled to go to your local mosque. The fault is not yours. The fault is the culture in your mosque and every other mosque that wounds believers. But the good news, Sister Sandy, is we can do communal Islam. Stacy, I'm sorry, Sister Stacy. We can do communal Islam in the field mosque. But at the same time, we're not abandoning, again, the physical mosque. I'm in it. We there. We doing it. We're going to cleanse it, purge it of the culture that is wounding beautiful Muslims like you and others and sending them out.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Praise be to Allah. And that's what I'm talking about, because Sister Stacy is a valuable person, and every single one of us are. And this is the work that we
Absolutely.
Have to do. Praise be to Allah, man. That's beautiful, Brother Wesley, which your words resonate deeply with
Allah.
Thing, brother. 6809, lines out the cave. Let's make it happen. 6809, go ahead. 6809, come on now. All right, we ain't got time. 6936, lines out the cage. 6936, go ahead. Get your phone off mute. 6936.
Walaikum Salaam.
Y'all know who this is. It's Brother Miguel.
Uh-oh.
Walaikum, Brother Miguel.
Walaikum Salaam.
We got to keep it short so we can get some questions, Lord.
So
we
want
to get some questions.
Wait a minute. I'm a wounded soldier. But I'm a wounded soldier.
Tuesday.
And I want to speak this
yes,
real quick.
Yes, you are.
Two things.
Yes, sir.
He did two things on Minister Ava's show tonight, too. He did two things in 30 minutes.
I talk real fast. Come on now.
Hey, no, bro. you are a wounded soldier whose testimony is very valuable.
Here we go. In 1994, I was witness to a meeting that occurred, well, it was actually over 3 days period of time in San Diego. And Minister Jibril was sent to San Diego to address the issues and ills of the believers and address their grievances. Mind you, I had just been in the nation for a year. Sacrificed military career, coming this, and I'm working my behind off, and we have this meeting. They allowed the sister to speak. The laboring staff could not speak. Each believer was allowed to air their grievances. By the time the third sister got up, because every sister that got up couldn't talk no more than 2 or 3 minutes before they got to tears. I can't stand to hear a sister cry. That just it reminds me of my mother. I can't do that. By the third sister, I had to walk out the room. I couldn't believe the stuff that I was hearing. Then I go through all of my trials and tribulations, like all the other believers go through, trying to do the right thing but facing opposition. And I want to remind everyone, and this is really to those that are wounded, 1995, the Million Man March. You got to understand that the opposition, the enemy, went to work. So to fast forward to 2006, when the minister says he doesn't have not one military mosque, I've been postulating all this time that, yes, since the Million Man March, they went to work. Running into the agent in D.C. that basically says that they have the nation all but like the church. So that just proves that they went to work. So all of this happened and transpired to those who have been victimized, brutalized, hurt, you know, sacrificed, all that. I feel your pain. I'm right there with you. Everybody on this line done been through sacrifice. But we're saying, hey, enough is enough. All I'm saying is just recall and remind yourself that that's not by accident. It's by design. But it's to take you through a process that once you get through this process, you are valuable. And the real work is in the field. Now, I just want to share this and I'm done. I'm in Las Vegas. I mean, I'm frustrated with things going on. The minister had, we had a West Coast regional meeting. Me and brothers drove down from Vegas to L.A. The minister is speaking. About halfway through the minister's presentation, what he was giving to us, some brothers were talking on the side. I ain't going to say their names, but those that were there remember. And the minister interrupted what he was saying, and he slammed this cuss on the roster. He said, God damn it, what the hell are you all on the side got to say that's more important than I have to say? They got quiet. The minister went on to speak, and he said, I know that there are hypocrites in hot places in the Nation of Islam, because during his presentation, he was making the comparison of the Islam during Prophet Muhammad's time, peace be upon him, and the Islam of today, and why the seed of hypocrisy was allowed to germinate in the three generations after him would be no longer up. So when the minister said that, what he said, when we left, me and the brothers were talking on the way back to Vegas. I said, you hear what the minister said? They said, yeah. I said, okay, if he knows and recognizes that there's a problem, my question is, how did it get that way? We all came to the same consensus that we allowed it. Don't care anything about the laboring position. That it's like what Dr. West said, it's about the culture. So we're at war with the culture. So I'm saying all that to say, look, this is the time for us to galvanize. I understand you've hurt. I feel your pain. The mosque is a re-stimulative environment if you want to apply Dianetics to it. And we understand that, but the real work is in the field. So maybe we got to do a triage with that, as we're doing this tour. Maybe we got to do a triage to address the wounds, but it ain't going to be no bit session. It's got to be, look, how do we move forward? Let's bandage you up, you know, whatever your issue is, and let's get this thing going. Because not only are we at war, but we're going to win this war. So we need all hands on deck. This is your time now. You want to work your aggression and your frustration out? This is your time. And bang on where that aggression needs to be banged on. I thank y'all for your time. I'm late.
Well, thank you for your testimony. Well, Lakin Salam.
That's real. 8754.
Yes,
we're on the winning team. 8754.
Yes,
go
sir.
Ahead.
As-salamu alaykum. Peace. This is Brother Michael from North Carolina.
Peace, Lord.
Peace, God. First, I want to say peace to Dr. Wesley Muhammad.
Peace, Black God.
I was showing some sisters the video where you was in Boston with Dr. Umar Johnson. Especially
yes,
the problem tonight. God do what God do and niggas do what niggas do. And if you were the
yes,
niggas,
sir.
Yes, sir.
We were watching that today. I had some sisters over building with them.
How did they receive that?
Oh, they enjoyed it. They supposed to come back tomorrow to watch some more videos. But I spoke with Brother Martin about me starting a study group up because it was the Lions Out of Cage that helped me to realize and understand, hey, even though I'm not in the mosque, I'm still part of the Nation of Islam. And,
right. And you be part of the field mosque.
Indeed. And I became a registered Muslim in Denver, Colorado. Then I moved to North Carolina after being in the Nation for 3 years. And I was in the minister's class in Denver. But when I got to North Carolina, it was a whole different reality from the study group I was in. And the minister down here and the captain, they were pushing final calls, but they didn't have enough FOI. So evidently they lied to Chicago because you're supposed to have so many FOIs and push so many papers. And so they had everybody dollar for dollar on the paper, and the stuff that they were doing kind of pushed me away. And I was driving 100 miles to Wilmington for FOI class, a Wednesday night meeting, Sunday. And they were giving me hell for trying to correct them and what they was doing. And so I kind of backed away, but I was still, you know, get the minister, I was still get the final call, but I just wasn't dealing with the mosque. And Allah team, I was following the web page when you had an interview with Rakim on there, and you had this little
yes, sir, yes, sir.
And so I held on to the teachings and the lessons. And so when I talked to Martin, after I got connected with the Lions Out the Cage, and he was like, look, start your own study group, and then after you get there, then present yourself to the minister or to a mosque, but go ahead and start in your area. So he done called and spoke to some brothers. I'm definitely, everything Brother Phil and them is putting out, the leadership group and everything, all that has been building me. Brother Mekiel, he just hit me on Facebook when I posted something about the men's meeting and coming together. So we sent up some for him to come down from Charlotte to connect. But what I want to say is, through me being dissatisfied with that study group and everything, I never turned my back on the teachers. I did a song called Long Live the Messenger to defend the minister during the time with the Dr. Khalid situation.
Yes, sir.
Also, I did a song Someday, and I sampled you in Dr. Wesley Muhammad, and I've been pushing that in the hood and pushing those.
Oh, yes, sir. True indeed. Oh, praise belongs to Allah. I know the song. Yeah, you sent it to me.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Beautiful song, beloved. Thank you. Yes, sir.
And appreciate you allowing me to utilize you in it.
I'm honored to be utilized in it, Lord.
Indeed. Mm-hmm. Yes, sir.
Real quick, I want to say to anybody that's listening on the line, 347-996-5718 is the phone number. If you're online, on your internet, on your computer, you need to call in the phone line right now if you want to continue this conversation. You have to get off your computer, pick up your phone, and call in right now or you're going to be disconnected. If you can get on the line, there's so many people on the line that it was overflowed before. But 347-996-5718. We're going to continue to take calls. 347-996-5718. Go ahead, Brother Michael.
Yes, sir. And what we want to do is we got about 6 calls in queue. We're going to let Brother Dr. Wesley, in case you all want to address him and everything, we're going to take these calls, and then we're going to call it to the night. Call it night. So if you want to talk, you better push 1 right now because we can't be here all night. This call will be the entirety, even this portion of it, will be on for archive. So for those brothers and sisters who can't get it all, you can get it all on the archive as soon as it's over. So go ahead, Brother Mike, and let's get busy.
Yes, sir. So I got a brother that's ordering wholesale The Message to the Black Man, Savior Arrives, and all the messenger books. Well, we've been sitting up in our own personal book club going through the Book of God, Encyclopedia, and the Truth of God, and using that
praise belongs to Allah.
So also show them that the black men are God. And so I've been incorporating the 120 with the Supreme Wisdom and Brother Waqil Allah's book as well, and been getting some of the brothers in the street that's game.
Praise belongs to Allah.
Now in the park, and they go in peace, God. And so that's a starting point.
Absolutely. Praise belongs to Allah.
Holding on to the teachings is what kept me from backing out from the nation, because I do believe Allah came in the person of Master Farah Muhammad. And so I'm out of age, y'all brothers are effective, real effective, and y'all
absolutely
been a big part of me standing back up and standing strong.
Praise belongs to Allah.
Can
praise
I say something real quick about your testimony, Chief? This is to you, Brother Michael, and to all of us wounded soldiers. This is a critically important point. Islam is not owned by those who wounded us. This Islam is yours, and you have every, not just right, you have a mandate to take ownership of this Islam. So that means, Brother Michael,
yes, sir,
you can teach Islam in your community. You can have a study group in your community. This is as much your Islam as it is anyone here in Chicago, with no exception. The minister would tell you that this Islam is as much yours as it is his.
Yes,
now,
sir.
He's our guide in how we grow in our Islam, because Allah has allowed him to grow so successfully in Islam, and he's our exemplar. But let's be real clear. We, every wounded soldier, Sister Stacy, Brother Michael, every wounded soldier should take ownership of this Islam and know that those who may have run you out, they ran you out of the mosque, but you did not leave your ownership papers there. You are not required to leave your ownership papers in the mosque when you left. You still got ownership of this Islam. It's still as really more yours than it is those who are participants in the culture of death.
Yes, sir.
And that's real. Understand that. Think about that. Work that out. Praise be to Allah. Let's get to another one real quick. Let's make it do what it do. Last four digits, 5759. Lines out the cage.
Assalamu alaikum.
Walaikum salam.
This is just your brother Jay Electronica chiming in again. I just want to sit here in the quiet and listen
wow.
with my family.
Man. Peace to the black God.
Peace to the black God.
All I just wanted to say was this is a most needed broadcast for the wounded soldiers. All I want to do is just sit here, let my presence be known, and listen.
Praise be to Allah. You got a new number.
You
want JLS.
Light on light.
No, sir. Brother Jay Electronica. No, sir. We cannot just let you sit and listen, brother, because we dealing with the wounded soldiers. The whole world witnessed the demonstration that you put on last weekend. Now, you spoke to Revolt TV, and you spoke of your own personal wounds. You have brothers and sisters from around the nation who are tuned in tonight because of their personal disposition and feelings of wanting to push the culture of Islam, and they're feeling some way inspired by what you've done. Can you share what it means to be a wounded soldier and to patch up your wounds and get back up on your square? Please share with the believers, brother.
Okay, yes, sir. Well, I mean, you know, I guess I would say that my wounds, I'm a different type of a wounded soldier, because my wounds are self-inflicted wounds. I never was ran out of a temple. I never was ran off of a program. I mean, there was those who have tried, but I just was too rebellious of a Muslim to let them ever back me down, you know. My wounds were self-inflicted, you know, as the wounds of the world, you know, taking on poisons, smoking, drinking, a lie here, a this there, a twosome, a threesome, this, you know, just these things that Satan makes fair semen, you know, and it's self-inflicted wounds. And, you know, I guess what I'm hearing tonight, I'm hearing a theme of those being affected by the wounds inflicted on them by others in the mosque, you know, but there's those out there who are inflicting themselves with wounds, you know. It's like always,
and I think
always,
we're all doing that. I think we're all doing that. Let's be real clear.
Yes, sir. I always would listen to, you know, the stories of my grandmother and my mother and my aunt about my uncles, right? I got two uncles, Uncle Charles and Uncle Ducky, that I've ever known them, they've always been good loving uncles to me, but they've always been one involved in crime, going in and out of prison, and one always involved in drugs or drinking or whatnot, right? And they would always tell me the stories of how clean and beautiful men that they were before this state. And they always attributed it to them going to the Vietnam War, saying that, you know, I had one uncle, he played for some farm baseball team, and he was supposed to go to scholarship and do all these wonderful things, great mathematician and everything. And then he went away to the Vietnam War, and there he got hooked on drugs. And, you know, and it's the same with us. You know, it's like a lot of us out here in the field, we out here in the battle zone, and a lot of times you get tired and beat down in war, you know what I mean? And sometimes you start to take on things to sedate yourself from the harsh reality or from the harsh pain that you experience, you know? And then you look up years down the line or however long time down the line, and you realize that you have become a victim to those things out here on the battlefield, you know? But, you know, that's my own personal testimony, self-inflicted wounds, you know? But we still out here on the battlefield. Every man have the power to pick himself up. We got the tools. The Honorable Elijah Muhammad gave us the message that was given to him by our Lord and Savior, and that's the only tools that we need to heal ourselves from the self-inflicted wounds or the wounds inflicted on us by others. You know, I really don't even feel qualified to say anything more, you know what I'm saying, about it. You know what I'm saying? That's why I said I just wanted to sit here and be quiet, because I just think that it's a most necessary topic to be talked about, because I know that it is. I know a lot of brothers that I come across. You know how you come across people in the street, oh, yeah, I used to be in the Nation, and
right,
I used to do
right,
that,
right.
So, and so, and so,
right.
And so,
right.
And you sit and you talk with these brothers and sisters, and you really see that, man, these people really love Islam. These people really
right.
love the minister and love the teachings, you know. And, you know, so I just think that what y'all are doing is a beautiful thing. I just want to sit here and listen, you know. And I think that it's important that y'all keep doing the same thing, because little do y'all know, like, let's say if allegorically speaking, I was a soldier out here in my own Vietnam, sedating myself with things to get through the everyday harsh realities of the war. It's important that y'all keep doing the things that y'all are doing, because when I was rotating in my darkness, I would click on YouTube and watch True Islam bomb the hell out of somebody in the name of Allah. I would click on Brother Philip and watch him bomb the hell out of somebody in the name of Allah, and it would actually fuel my fire and help me build myself back up in the darkness when I was working on myself in the darkness. So I think that's a big part of it too, that every believer out there on their post, like the ones that's out there on their post, got to stay on their post, because you never know who is looking at you and who have a biblical core attached to you, feeding off of your great works, you know? You know, and I just want to say I thank y'all. I thank the God True Islam. I thank the God Brother Philip for out here being out here in the jungles and banging, because when I was down and wounded, y'all helped save my life. Oh, I don't want to cry, brother.
Oh, man.
Oh, P.
Peace to the black dog.
I just want to thank the gods, man.
Praise be to Lord.
And we thank you, black dog. Look.
Yes, sir.
Yours is a God. I told you, yours is a testimony crafted by Allah Himself. The testimony that you're giving, the demonstration that you're putting down, is a demonstration that is and will continue to breathe a lot of life into a lot of people, because yours is that straight God, black God demonstration, which means, like I posted, the black gods of antiquity, their godhood was suspect until they conquered death. They didn't get their black god bona fides until after they conquered death. And your black god bona fides is on swole, Lord. The death that you are in the process of conquering makes you qualified to wear the title that we throw around in this nation, especially in the God nation, to a living God. See, most of us, we can't really wear the title true and living because we ain't been tested. We don't have on our resume that we really overcome death. You have, Lord. You know, we all were born in death, but the death I'm talking about is after having knowledge and then being victimized by Satan's world. We all, to one degree. But the real godhood comes when we overcome the best that Satan has to offer. That's godhood.
Right.
And your testimony is like you. Yeah, go ahead, Lord.
Let me say this, Lord. It's like this. The only difference between mud and the cream is how high you raise, you rise. We are the cream. We start off as mud, but we're going to rise like cream. And the thing about it is, some of us are blessed because our trials are kept hidden from the public. Many of us, our trials is in front of the public. And so praise be to Allah that Allah has made our shoulders strong enough to bear going through not only our trials that all of us go through, but the fact that we can go through our trials in front of other brothers, in front of other sisters, and the criticisms and the critics. It's this. Allah does not put a burden on our shoulders that we are not strong enough to bear. Praise be to Allah. Jay Electronica, because you are a public figure, you have a hell of a burden. We all do. And if we step out in front of y'all, brothers and sisters, it's not to take your place. It's to take the bullet. We can take it. So I pray that Allah continues to bless Dr. Wesley, Jay Elect, the Allah team, every one of y'all on this line tonight. Understand something. Allah is working with us. We are a work in progress. You understand?
Absolutely.
And we got to get mud on us because that mud purifies. Mud is dirt and water strangely mixed. And life comes out
Absolutely.
Of black mud. You understand? I ain't never seen a birth, like I said before, that's clean and neat. We are looking
Absolutely.
At brotherhood.
That was a good point. That was a good point.
Brotherhood
that was good.
Is on the march. This is what brotherhood looks like. When we can
Absolutely.
Cover each other's faults and continue to love one another and defend each other. We don't make excuses for our mistakes. We own it. We own it.
Absolutely.
And then we get through it.
Yes, sir.
Praise be to Allah. That's what it is. Peace
to
Brother Elect. Let's take a few more calls, man. You can't have this particular conversation and Allah's not involved.
That's
we
right.
are on the winning
Real
team.
Talk.
We are on the – we've already won. We just got to take the damn
we
prize.
We already won.
0304. Sorry, brother.
Walaikum
salam. Are you fired up? Are you on the winning team? What's happening?
This is Sister Jamila. How y'all doing, brothers?
Well, how about yourself?
I'm in Dallas by way of Philadelphia.
Right.
And,
belongs to Allah.
Yep.
I just want to say to Brother Philip and Brother Martin, I am so proud of y'all. And I say that because I have a sort of a personal connection with you brothers since you guys came to Philadelphia back in 2010. And, of course, I had y'all back, and I still do.
Right.
And I've been following y'all for a minute, and I'm down. I'm ready, you know. I'm a little different, you know. I'm not your average sister, so y'all speak for me, you know. Y'all speak through that feeling that I always had. I've always been active in Mosque number 12. I've got wonderful training and teaching, and I'm ready to be in the field. I'm ready to bring y'all to Dallas so we can represent, because Dallas is asleep, and they need help. And so it's going to be a sister that's going to make it happen, and I'm going to bring y'all brothers here, and we going to light this thing on fire. And I am. I'm fired up. And
hey,
it was good to hear from Brother Jay Electronica. I know him by Brother Tim. We go way back. He was a teacher for my son back in second grade. And I'm so proud of you, brother, if you still listen. I'm so proud of you for being who you are and for inspiring all the young people. I've been following your career, and I'm just real happy that the brothers is really making it happen. We're trying to get the sisters on the streets to make things happen as well. So I just wanted to call in to congratulate y'all on this movement, and I fully support y'all 150%.
Yes, sir. Yes, ma'am. Brother Wesley, this is the sister I talked to earlier who wants to bring us in September 28th. Sister Jamila, you got to reach out to Sister Erica Muhammad from Atlanta on Facebook and make sure you get with her, because she's creating a database. But Brother Wesley, this is the sister who wants to bring us in September 28th. So praise be to Allah that she's on the line right now.
That's E-R-I-K-A Muhammad on Facebook, Sister Jamila.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, no problem.
Let's make it do what it do. Thanks for the love, man. That's what I'm talking about. Listen, 2594, lines out the cage, 2594. Go ahead.
Uh-oh, wasn't expecting that. Can y'all hear me?
Yes. Go ahead, Queen.
Salaam alaikum.
I'm calling. I've been listening to a few of the comments, and at first I was doing like Brother Jay. I was just going to sit back and listen. But I just made a comment on Dr. Wesley's Instagram about the culture of the mosque and what you're talking about. And unfortunately, I've been a victim of that, and I really didn't want to harp on it because sometimes I don't like to highlight the negative, especially on a public forum like we're doing, but then sometimes we got to just talk about it and keep it real and keep it moving.
Yes, we do.
So for me, I'm a sister that was basically raised on the teachings, period. Like, my dad is a registered member of the nation, and ever since I can remember, I've been listening to the minister on red and white cassette tapes for as long as I can remember. We hop in the car, that's what we're listening to. It was never the radio, so I didn't understand at the time why my dad was doing it, but, you know, he's like, Dad, we want to listen to something else, but no, we're going to listen to the minister.
Is this Sister Malika?
Don't be knowing my voice. Yes. This is
Praise
Malika.
Allah, so Allah. Yes, ma'am. It's wonderful. Go ahead.
So, you know, finally it's come around in like the last 6 years. My sister and I have really been inspired to go on ahead and push forward with actually registering to become members. Now, we did go to the MUI. And the whole nine. So it's the love is already there. It's already there. But unfortunately, as I made those strides to get closer to, you know, I turned in my letter. I did all the things that was necessary to really, really, really just go on and lock it down and become an official registered member of the nation. It seemed like instead of me getting the love, I was getting the hated on. And I was like, hold on, this is starting to feel like what I went through in high school. And I'm used to it.
Same old shit.
I'm really used to it. And to me, I'm not getting goofy. So I'm looking at it like, hold on, I wasn't expecting this, but every day after I would come home and my dad would just sit down with us and say, look, the teachings are perfect. The people are not. If you want to be the change that you need to be the change that you want to see. So just keep going.
Yeah.
Don't be discouraged. Just keep going. So I go and I do it and I do all of these things. But saying all that to say, I have been, I want to say more disappointed than discouraged, like I'm listening to it at home. I want to go to my mosque. I want to do all of those things. But in all honesty, I had to tell a sister the other day, I don't even really want to sit with y'all in the MGT class, and I'm just keeping it real, and I know that we should. And so we can talk about it and discuss it, and we know that it's a culture, but what do we do about that to remedy that? You know, how do we rectify that and not have that be an issue anymore? Because I'm going to tell you like this. If I didn't already have the love that I have because my parents raised us on Pan-Africanism, Islam, and just a love of our people, I would have been not even looking at it no more. You know, I invite people, but I'm always thinking, dang, if I was another just random sister that somebody convinced me to come to the mosque and I listened to it and I loved it and I pushed and I done all the wonderful things that I feel that I'm doing not to get no kudos from them because I really love it, I would have been gone or I would have probably packed somebody down or something like that. So how do we get past that point? Because it's not a good thing that now it's actually kind of slowed down my process. I'm not really going as much, and I don't want to do that. And I'm still active on the outside, but I want to be on the inside, and I don't see myself as a lobby dweller. And I feel like I've done a lot of things, and I've come to the mosque, and the sister asked me something like, well, are you still a believer? Oh, disregard that text that you got the other day. That's only for MGT. And I'm like, all kind of just sideways stuff. And it's just, it's unfortunate because I know that the love has been planted in me so deep that it's nothing that can take that away. It's no one sister or brother that can ever do that. But I think about another sister that may not be as strong as I know I am or as resilient as I know I am that just would say, forget it. How many sisters out there have been treated like I have been that just, it may be thousands that just have said forget it, and it's missing out on all the wonderful teachings because I still tune in. So we could talk about it, but then what do we need to do about it? And like
that is an important question.
It's not necessarily been self-inflicted, but I have to be the person that just rises above that emotion, and that's what I'm trying to do right now. But just listening in, I'm like, this is just too hitting it too real right now. And then my sister, she to the point where she like, girl, you can go, but I'm trying to enjoy my Sunday. I don't feel like leaving the mosque pissed off today. And I'm like, oh.
I'm mad at her for that. We understand.
You know, so what do we do about it? And we're going to, Ubaka sisters, we're going to keep pushing on. And whoever's listening, it's unfortunate, but it is what it is. So the love is there because I love my people. And I just really, really love, you know, how the minister gave us the 8 steps of atonement. I love it.
Yes,
if you got a problem with me, talk to me about it. Let's go over it. Let's point out what we did and keep it moving because, like you said, we at war. It's too much going on for you to set trip off of, my head wrap ain't covering 2 inches.
Yeah,
of
it is.
You know,
it is.
So that's my 2 cents.
that's
you,
a wounded soldier testimony.
A wounded soldier.
Before I add it on, did either other guys want to add on to that?
No, I'm with you. Go ahead and get some advice to the queen, brother.
Well, the important question was raised. What do we do? My suggestion is this. But first, let me disabuse you of any fear that you're exposing anything. We put this show together for a purpose. This is public. Look, this is a social media, the internet age. Ain't nothing secret.
Right.
The culture of death that has taken root in the mosque, everybody know it. It ain't no secret to many people. We are, in order for us, for wounded soldiers to be reached, we have to communicate outside the mosque because the wounded soldiers rightfully not coming to the mosque. So the testimony you gave is a testimony that we are soliciting by putting this particular demonstration on. In terms of what we do, 2 things. But there's a burden, the responsibility of those like myself, Brother Philip, Brother Martin, those of us who are still in the mosque, we have an obligation to be in the mosque and fighting for change. One, to be the change you want to see. That's the first responsibility that every single one of us have. You said it correctly. We have to individually be the change. That is not cliche or rhetoric. That's literally, we have to do our Islam in the way we think Islam should be done in the mosque. That's first. Second, those of us who are in the mosque, we have an obligation
to fight it. I asked the minister a very candid, pointed question. We in the Nation of Islam, we see Eric Snowden, America sees Eric Snowden as a traitor. We have come out with on the position that Eric Snowden, no, it's not a traitor. He's a patriot. And so Eric Snowden revealed corruption in the House. I asked the minister, Eric Muhammad, if there was the parallel, an Eric Snowden, but who's a registered Muslim, is he a patriot or a traitor? He said he's a patriot. The fact of the matter is we have an obligation, what, in the mosque, to fight regardless of whom or what for what's right. We have an obligation to not co-sign the evil because it's more comfortable for us to get along. We don't have that luxury. We have a mandate to fight that. The other thing, the wounded soldiers who have been driven out of the mosque, you need to know that the field mosque is a reality. So while we still try to get with our mosque, but if your local mosque isn't being inviting to you, isn't opening its doors to you, that's cool. While we work that crap out, know that you could still do your Islam community. That's what this movement that the LOTC and the Allah team and other subgroups are about, to make the field mosque a reality for all the believers. So you know that your only alternative is not going getting a headache in your local mosque. You can still do communal Islam. That's what this movement is about. So you can still do communal Islam because that's what we do. And while we're doing that, we are fighting to uproot the culture that the minister said is flatlined and replace it with a culture that will be more welcoming to soldiers like yourself.
Yes,
praise
sir.
Be to Allah. Let's continue to work. Sister, you can, hold on. So you can reach out to Sister Erica Muhammad, too, on Facebook for a latching and lines out the cage and pull our resources and we can get busy. We need you. Praise be to Allah.
Definitely.
You
do. I'm really right now trying to use my music, not trying, using my music as a channel and also my education, mixing that in, getting out there in the community. So I'm definitely in the community, but I'll still be going to the mosque and all that. But right now I'm really trying to use the music as a tool to gather my peers and my people. So I'm pushing.
Right now you are a registered member in the field. You registered.
For sure.
You registered.
Exactly.
Praise be to Allah.
All right, brother.
So keep
up the good work. Brother, and by the way, Brother Warren sent out the mass text because I hadn't even listened to this program. So now I'm going to be tuning in and online with you, brothers, from here on out.
We appreciate you. Thank you, Queen.
Peace. All right.
That's what it do. Let's keep moving, man. It's late. Let's get these in. 7917 lines out the cage. Let's roll.
Let's go. Lines out the cage.
Well,
yes, sir. It's Brother Daoud from Alabama. Ramadan Kareem, sir. I would just like to bear witness to the wounded soldier, but I'm no longer wounded. But years ago when I first came in, I came in sincere, came in ready to help resurrect our people. But time went by that you realized that there's people who are going to abuse you. They're going to look at your talent and the image of your talent. So those are things I went through and I left in 97. If I wouldn't have left, there would have been fights and all that stuff. When I left, I was very wounded. I couldn't understand. So I went back to doing what I used to do, which was partying, drinking, and just wilding out. But in 2000, January, is when the minister was bearing witness to his near-death experience. I think it was Savior's Day. But little did I know in 2000 of June that I would suffer severe illness which impacted my kidneys. And I went into kidney failure.
So from 2000 to 2008, I was at the mosque, but I was studying and preparing for my return. But in that process, when the minister bear witness, when he was on his deathbed, when I went through my trial, I reflected back on the minister, how he said, he cried out to Allah and said, whatever your will, let it be done. And once that reminded me of that, that kept me alive. So once, for 8 years, I was on that dialysis machine. For 2 years on the dialysis, well, a month after I was on dialysis, I was called in to get a kidney. I turned it down. As I turned it down, I didn't think I was mentally ready. So another year later, they called me again. We got a kidney. I turned it down again. Little did I know they were going to call me again the third time. The third time I accepted the kidney. Once I accepted the kidney, it was more like Allah saying, now it's time for you to go back to work inside the house and be that change, as Brother Dr. Wesley would say, be that change for the believers who are out there wounded and try to correct, as he was eloquent speaking about, the culture of how we hate on each other inside the mosque. And as I started elevating myself and study, I remember reading your book, Dr. West, one of the books which you was dealing with, the black God, and the message saying that Prophet Muhammad was black and all that. And I remember telling the believers that, some of the believers that one day over dinner, and they thought I was crazy because they were trying to say, well, he don't know what he's talking about. The only thing I know is what I bear witness and check the references, this is what the messenger said.
Yes,
so little did I know, after that, some of the same believers who thought I was crazy, now they ride with Dr. Wesley and his book.
That's right.
Seeing you up there in Chicago.
It's called growth.
Yeah.
It's called development.
Yeah.
Praise
yes, sir. Well,
thank you for your testimony, brother. And I don't want to cut
yes,
you.
Sir.
We got two more calls. I love you, brother. Continue to listen.
Yes, sir.
I thank Allah for you and your spirit
thank you
and
for that
you made it through. Let's make
yes,
you
sir.
Do what it do, man. And let's reach out
that's
with
right.
that love to everybody we come in contact with. Let's do that.
Yes,
and
sir.
We're
right.
happy
praise
to have
Allah.
You as a registered member of the field, Muhammad's field.
Welcome to the family.
Power card, Muhammad's field.
That's what I'm talking about. That's what's happening.
Praise big fields. Let's raise the dead by the thousands. Slum
that's
like
right.
Them.
Yes,
thousands.
8965 lines out the cage. Let's get this done. We got two more calls. Walling Salam.
It's Brother Akbar in St. Louis.
Peace,
Brother Akbar.
Peace to the gods, man. I just wanted to say, you know, ever since I first heard lines out the cage, I was with you, brothers. I mean, just you know, I used to call in the show all the time, but I knew something was gonna come down. That was going to be great. After a while, I didn't know what, but now I see this is what it is. And now with the Allah team and spearheading that movement that we really needed in the mosque, I never knew how it was going to come. I know when the minister said that the Honorable Elijah Muhammad said that the nation would never fall again, he said, why wouldn't it fall? The minister said, because we won't let it. Who is that we? I'm
yes,
talking
sir.
To that we now, the beginning of that I see. You know, we need this, and this discussion tonight is so important, brothers, because, you know, we all wounded. We wound each other. We wounded ourselves.
Yes, we do.
You know, and something has to change. I think this is the beginning of it. And to hell with the naysayers, those of us that just want this and love this, that snowball is going to keep growing and growing and growing. I'm glad to be a part of it myself, and I'm glad to talk to these titans, the lions out the cage, and the Allah team. I love you, brothers.
We
That's
love you,
back,
Titan. And thank you, Brother Akbar, for always supporting us, brother, and spreading the word. Let's keep doing
yes,
what
sir.
We do. Sorry. I'm sorry. I didn't mean that. But let's get this last call in. 6716, lions out the cage. Go ahead.
Assalamu alaikum. This is Jacqueline Hollowell. I just wanted to know what... Okay, thank you. I just want to know, what are you doing to target Christians, people that go to church? And here's why I asked that question. Elijah Muhammad, the Honorable Elijah Muhammad, he approached me in the person. I do have studied. I grew up as a Christian. I grew up in the mosque. I also studied in the mosque when I was in college. So I've been a mosque number one. I'm out of Detroit. But I've witnessed him in the person, in the flesh, and he's been with me ever since. I mean, my background, it kind of makes sense why I was selected, and we don't have time this evening to go into all the details, but what are you doing to target those individuals that are willing, that are submitting to do the will of God, but maybe they don't have the leadership in churches? I know we talked a lot about not having the happiest experiences in the mosque, but there's experiences that are going on in churches that are not fulfilling to our community. So do we have a strategy around targeting all God's children? Because as we know, Master Farah Muhammad, he came in the person, and that is the second coming of Jesus. So that's pretty much all I had to say tonight.
Brother Martin, you got something on that, brother? Because I know you're good at that, brother. Come on.
Yes, sir. Sister Jacqueline, the first thing that we can do to target our Christian family is by simply responding to the six words that were given to us by the Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad, and that's accepting our own and being ourselves. Our purpose is to be righteous Muslims. A Muslim is one who submits his or her will to do God's will. And that is the same responsibility as any good Christian, who is to be crystallized into the oneness of God and who strives to be Christ-like. We have one and the same mission, that's an obedience to the one God. So if we would be our righteous selves, we would be a light to those who would follow the Christ as we strive to follow the Christ. So we are in the big fields, and we are reaching our brothers and sisters in the streets, in the pool halls, in the drug houses, and in the church. And we're going after the brothers and sisters who are living wayward lifestyles, whether it be homosexual or what have you, in our communities. So the Christian church is definitely, that's our house too. Wherever God's name is being held up, that's our house. So we in that piece. So we want to make sure that we create more avenues to where we can have open dialogue and communication. So whatever that you can do or you would like to do to aid and assist the Lions Out the Cage and the Allah team to press forward in demonstrating our love for our Christian family, please help aid and support us, because we want to be one in Christ.
And I'll add on to this, that the greatest magnetic we can ever offer to our people is a strong sisterhood and brotherhood. Love is going to transcend all language and labels. We just have to create a strong, beautiful, powerful brotherhood and sisterhood. We have to be the example that we expect and that we want. So all we have to do is show love, true brotherhood, true sisterhood, really be sincere in our service to our brothers and sisters. We don't go to try to convert. Let's just give them the truth. Let's talk about it. Let's talk about the things that we can agree on. We ain't got to ridicule and talk about the blue-eyed Jesus, the blue-eyed, blonde-haired Jesus, and talk about poor. Let's settle on the best part and allow our relationship to grow so we can withstand a good, healthy debate. Praise be to Allah. I want to say to the brothers and sisters who's listening that we appreciate Dr. Wesley coming out. He's a busy man. We're all busy. And for him to take out his time, not just to spend time on Sister Ava's show radio program and as well as ours, this is a beautiful brother, and everything he shared with us is wisdom. Dr. Wesley is our friend. He's an example of brotherhood. And everybody who's with the Lions Out the Cage and the Allah team, we are all brothers and we are all sisters. Ain't nobody on this line better than any other of us. We all are unique and special.
Absolutely.
And our desire
Absolutely.
And duty is to show forth how beautiful and special each one of us are. If we, please forgive us if we have said anything to make us be the center of attention, because we do not desire that. We only
right.
desire to point you to yourself. Dr. Wesley, we're
right.
going to end it now. I want you to close out with your wise words, G. We got a lot of work to do in Philadelphia, New York, Atlanta, Cincinnati, Texas. We just getting started. If y'all want to support, go to www.lotcleadershipgroup.com. Drop something on it, because we ain't getting no outside support. Everything we do is by the grace of Allah and him working through men and women like you. Go ahead, Dr. Wesley, brother.
Well, peace. I appreciate that. I'll be real, real short. But I think the point of this show, if we weren't clear, all wounded soldiers, we are appealing to you. We want to connect with you. This movement, in many ways, of the Allah team and the Lions Out the Cage, and Lions Out the Cage and the Allah team, in many ways, it's for you. We're targeting you. We want you. We want to connect with you. This is a field mosque movement. And I would hope with all my being that any and every wounded soldier who still love this Islam, who still love Farad, Elijah, and Farrakhan, that you hear our call, that you get the mosque is here for you. It's the field mosque now, but the mosque is here for you. You can do your Islam communally again. Connect with us. Connect with the Allah team. Connect with the Lions Out the Cage, because we want you a part of this movement, because that's what Farrakhan wants. Farrakhan is to deliver all of the lost found, all of God's people to the Lamb of God. That includes you as much as it does Brother Philip or myself. So let's go to the Lamb of God with Farrakhan together. No, you don't have to struggle with the crap in the mosque if that's not what you can take right now, but that don't mean you can't get with the mosque, expanded mosque, and get with Farrakhan to be delivered to the Lamb of God. So we hope you communicate it to y'all. Get with us. We want to get with you. This is that day for wounded soldiers to come back home. You ain't got to go to the crowd. We're working on that. That is still the hub, and we're going to get that right. But you don't have to wait until then in order to come to the mosque. The field mosque.
Praise be to Allah. And with that, we say peace. May Allah bless you and your family. And look here, we got another talk show, talk program that's going to go on. What's today? It's today, Thursday. So our next talk is going to be on Sunday. Praise be to Allah. Subject is to be announced. May y'all have a good night. Allah be with you. Peace.
Peace.